This quick guide will show you how to save data as comma-separated values and then read it into R. A quick summary is to save your data as .csv, save an R markdown file in the same location, set your working directory to source file location, and then run reads.csv and between quotation marks the name of your data.csv. If you have an Excel sheet, go to File, Save As, and then choose a location for your file and select from the drop-down menu comma separated values or comma delimited with the file extension .csv. Then click Save. If you have a Google Sheets file, go to File, Download, and then choose comma separated values .csv. This will download the file to your default download location, and you can press the arrow next to it and select Show in Folder to see where it is and move it to the folder you want to work in. Next, open RStudio and create a new R Markdown file. You can do so by going to File, New File, and then select R Markdown. What you choose here doesn't matter because you can change it anytime later, so just press OK and you'll end up with this standard template. In the video linked in the description, I explain everything in this template, but for now, simply delete everything after the preamble and then save your R Markdown file to the same location as your dataset. Now there are two steps left. First, we're going to tell R where to find your data by going to Session, Set Working Directory, to Source File Location. Finally, create a new code chunk and type the following: df, assignment operator, read.csv, open brackets, open quotation mark, and then the name of your data.csv. Be sure to include .csv at the end and make sure you enclose the name in quotation marks or it won't work. Also, if you're using a version of Excel that uses a comma as a decimal separator, replace read.csv with read.csv2, and then it should work correctly. Run this line with Ctrl Enter on Windows or Command Enter on Mac, or by pressing the play button, and then you'll see a new object stored in the object space called df. If you see this and it has the right dimensions, then it probably worked correctly. If you run into errors, make sure you followed each step as explained, and note that R is case sensitive, so for example, capital letter reads.csv won't work. You can view your data by clicking on it or by typing view df in the console and pressing enter. You can also perform some basic checks that your data has been read correctly into R by running heads df, which shows the first six rows, str df, which shows the structure, or summary df, which shows a basic summary of your data frame. Of course, you're free to name your data whatever you want. I use df here as a shorthand for data frame because it takes little space and is easy to type. If you're going to do any kind of analysis, you'll probably be typing this name a lot, so short names are preferable. However, if you're working with multiple data frames at once, you'll probably want to use something a little more informative than just df. The last thing I want to say is that there are many other correct ways to read your data. However, if your dataset is not too large, then this is the least likely to give you any kind of trouble. Thank you for watching.